So I've got a copy of the work from last time. I've named it 919, CBDD0919. Here's our project so far, all the supporting libraries and files, CSS files, JavaScript files, and all of the main work is happening in the index file for the visuals. And all the actual hard work of the app working is happening in the myjs.js file. So you can open both in Notepad. Here's a trick: if you control-click both of them, if you select both the index.html and the myjs, if you select them both, control-click, you can then right-click and open them both in Notepad at the same time. So you can quickly open them both. Once they're both selected, right-click and open them both. I mentioned previously also there's a way to do split screen view. Right now, if you have two or more files open, you've got them in tabs. If you want to separate them into two views, you can right-click one of the tabs and select Move to Other View from the bottom there, Move to Other View. And then you've got split screen, so you can look at two files at once. I usually will not do this because my screen is smaller than yours and it's harder to see two things at once. But you guys, since you have nice larger monitors, you can do the split view and you'll be able to see more code at once. And to put it back, you can right-click the tab again and select Move to Other View. I also mentioned what's useful is if you've got a long file, so my index file at the moment goes up to about 100 lines, if you wanted to look at code in the first few lines and look at code at the last few lines, you can do a right-click on the file and this time clone to other view. So on one window, you've got one panel, you've got part of your code, and on the other one, you've got another part. So you can look at two pieces of the code in the same file. Here's my first 30 lines, and here's my last 30 lines, for example. And that's right-clicking, move to other view, or clone to other view. Load up my index file to remind myself what it looks like so far. Remember, open up that developer's panel as soon as possible. We're going to look at a lot of output in the developer's console. And in Firefox, I like to move the panel to the right. So I'll move it to the right. And our login doesn't really do anything yet. We're still setting up the new user registration. I can go to sign up. There's a whole sign up procedure. Victor@victor.com, password ABC, password ABC, join, and my output in the console is at least showing that it is recognizing that my password's matched. That's where we last left off. If the passwords didn't match, it would recognize that. It would clear my password inputs. And so far in the console, it's giving output. In a moment, we'll have it actually give user visual output. But our algorithm for this whole login is on track. The algorithm to register a new user. The unofficial homework over the weekend, which was what? Look at local storage. How many of you did it? Okay, 10 points for you, minus 10 for everyone else. We're going to look at local storage and apply it to the project. So, very briefly, I will look up local storage online. Plenty of tutorials out there. I'm going to go look at the developer.mozilla version. After all, as I said before, Mozilla is one of the big names in web development. They were one of the forefathers of all of this. They developed JavaScript back in the day. They had Netscape Navigator, the most popular browser